oxidation and reduction reactions. In this, we will study about concept of oxygen, concept of hydrogen, electronic concept of oxidation and reduction, and oxidation state method. So before to start the concept of oxygen, let us understand about what is oxidation and reduction. As you can see here, I have already written, oxidation means in oxidation reaction there is a addition of oxygen take place, okay, or loss of hydrogen or removal of hydrogen occur. So if there is a addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen or loss of hydrogen takes place, so that is the oxidation, okay. And in reduction reaction, what happens? There is a addition of hydrogen and or loss of oxygen takes place. Okay, now let's start our first one, that is the concept of oxygen. So in this case, you can see reaction. What happens when an element gain the oxygen? Okay, so what happens here? You can see sulfur. After gaining the oxygen, it becomes oxidized. It becomes sulfur dioxide. Here it is sulfur, but after the addition of oxygen, it becomes sulfur dioxide. Means it is sulfur become here becomes sulfur what? Oxidized. Okay. Similarly, carbon when add there is the addition of oxygen, then it become carbon become oxidized. Okay, so it become carbon dioxide. From carbon, it become carbon dioxide. Okay. And third one, you can see it is methane, means CH4. Okay, so here what happened, there is a loss of hydrogen. Here hydrogen will remove, and what happened, carbon plus we will get hydrogen gas over here. So here what happened, hydrogen is removed from the carbon. Okay, so it become what, C plus H2. So when there is a addition of oxygen, here you can see addition of oxygen, first two reaction, or the loss of hydrogen. Here what? Loss of hydrogen. So it is what? It is the oxidation. Now concept of hydrogen. So here you can see calcium plus hydrogen. It become calcium hydride, Ca plus H2. So here what happened? Here what is going on? That is the addition of hydrogen. Okay. So it become what? It become reduced because it is adding the hydrogen. Okay, add of hydrogen become reduction. So here what happened, that is the addition of hydrogen takes place, so it become calcium become reduced here. So it is a reduction reaction. And next is what, loss of oxygen. So here we will see that this is, you can see HGO. Okay, so mercury second oxide. So here you can see here oxygen is there, and on product side you can see what happened, that mercury there is a loss of oxygen takes place. So mercury plus oxygen we will get here. So there is a loss of oxygen in the second reaction. So what happened in first one, addition of hydrogen taking place, okay, and second one, loss of oxygen. So when there is a addition of hydrogen, that is reduction, or there is a removal or loss of oxygen here, so it is also a reduction reaction. Now, electronic concept of oxidation and reduction. Here, oxidation means loss of electrons and reduction means gain of electrons. So when there is a loss of electrons, that is the oxidation reaction, and when there is a gain of electron, then that is the reduction reaction. Okay. Now, let us understand first of all oxidation reaction. Okay, according to the electronic concept. So according to this electronic concept of oxidation, here examples I have written, that is sodium Na, okay, minus one electron. So here sodium is sodium symbol is Na, and its atomic number is what, 11. Okay, so when it lose its one electron, then it become 10. Okay, after losing one electron, it become 10, and it gain the positive charge on it. So Na become Na positive Na plus after losing the one electron. So sodium becomes sodium cation. Okay, usually the oxidation reaction shows by the metals, and the reduction reaction is usually show by the non-metals. Okay, so here you can see all the metals and here all the non-metals. So when the sodium, why now question is that why sodium or the metals here the sodium, magnesium and aluminium is losing the electrons. So why they are losing? So that they become stable and their electronic configuration become equal to its nearest noble gas. So sodium, you know that 11 having the electrons. Okay, atomic number 11 having the 11 electrons. So after losing the one electron, what become? It become having the 10 electrons. So its electronic configuration become what? From 2, 8, 1. Okay, I am writing here so it become clear for you. So sodium is what having the atomic number, that is the 11. Okay, it is what? It is 2, 8, 1. Okay, and after losing the one electron from its outermost shell, its electronic configuration become what? It become 2, 8. Means its electronic configuration is become equal to the that nearest noble gas, that is the neon. Okay, similarly in magnesium. In magnesium also you can see having atomic number 12, electronic configuration 2, 8, 2. So after losing the 2 electron, it become stable Mg2+. So its electronic configuration become 2, 8, means stable. Okay, to its nearest noble gas. Similarly, aluminium having 2, 8, 3, 13 atomic number. After losing the 3 electron from the outermost shell, it become 2, 8. Okay, now it become Al3+, that is the stable. Okay, so sodium cation here we will get, magnesium cation and aluminium cation. Okay, now what is cation? So cation means when an atom loses an electron to form positive ion. Okay, and here I have written that is the anion term here, because here the non-metals and non-metals usually gain the electron. Okay, so after gaining the electron, you can see chlorine is there, atomic number 17, 287 electronic configuration. So it chlorine want one electron, so it gain the one electron and become stable it become 288, that is Cl negative, because it is gaining the one electron. So now chlorine become what? Chlorine anion. Now it is stable. Okay, and its electronic configuration is equal to its nearest noble gas, that is the argon. Similarly, sulfur 286, after gaining 2 electron, it become S2 negative sulfur anion. From 286, it become 288. Nitrogen having 7 atomic number, 25 electronic configuration. It want 3 electrons, so it gained 3 electrons and then become N3 negative nitrogen anion with electronic configuration 28. Okay, so this is the electronic concept of oxidation and reduction. So anion means when an atom gain an electron to form negative ion. Okay, here you can see negative ion, Cl negative, S2 negative, N3 negative, and here positive for the cation. Now next is oxidizing and reducing agents. Here I have written the one reaction, that is you can see copper oxide plus hydrogen, then right hand side the product side, that is the copper plus H2O water. So here what is going on, actually you can see here copper with oxygen. Okay, and here what happened, copper lose the oxygen. Okay, so there is a loss of oxygen. You can see copper oxide become copper. So what is happen here, that copper loses the oxygen. So this you can, copper oxide, okay, I have written here loss of oxygen. Okay, so if there is a loss of oxygen, then what happens, it is a reduction reaction. So when here copper loses the oxygen, so it is the reduction reaction, and it means that copper become reduced. Okay, next you can see hydrogen, that is the H2. Okay,
Now, right hand side you can see H2O. Okay, there is an addition of oxygen. Okay, so there is a gain of oxygen. So it means that hydrogen become oxidized. So this reaction is what? Oxidation reaction. Now, one term is there, that is the term is there, oxidizing agent, OA, reducing agent, RA. Now, what is oxidizing agent? Oxidizing agent means which oxidize any other substance. Okay, so here copper is losing its oxygen, but it is oxidized to whom? It is oxidizing to hydrogen. So copper oxidizes the hydrogen, that's why copper is what? Oxidizing agent. And what is reducing agent? The substance that reduces the another substance. So here hydrogen reduces the copper by taking its oxygen. Okay, hydrogen taken the oxygen of copper. So hydrogen reduce the copper. So that's why it is what? It is the reducing agent. Okay. Now, what is redox reaction? So here I have split it. Okay, you can see I have split it. Redox reaction. So here R-E-D means reduction and O-X for oxidation. So in redox reaction, both oxidation and reduction takes place. Okay, so here reaction I have written, that is the tri-lead tetraoxide or red lead, you can call it PB3O4, its formula, plus it react with carbon to form lead and carbon dioxide. So here you can see what happened here. Here tri-lead tetraoxide is there. Okay, so this is the left hand side. Here oxygen, you can see it loses the oxygen. So what happened? It become lead. Okay, so here what is going on? Actually here there is a loss of oxygen. So if there is a loss of oxygen, that is what? That is means lead become reduced. So it is what? It is a reduction reaction. Okay, it loss its oxygen, that's why it become reduced. So it is the reduction reaction. Whereas you can see carbon. Okay, now carbon there what? Carbon become oxidized because it gained the oxygen. Okay, so that's why carbon become oxidized. So that is the oxidation reaction. So we will write here carbon. Okay, carbon, what happened to the carbon? It gained the oxygen. It become what? It gained oxygen. That's why it is a oxidation reaction. So in redox reaction, what is going on? Both gain of oxygen is also going on and reduction of oxygen also takes place. So reduction as well as oxidation both takes place. So that's why it is the what? It is redox reaction.